Hey guys, Paul here from Military History Gear Review, and today we are going to be checking out a classic. These are Russian Kirza boots. This is the boot that was manufactured in the Soviet Union from the 1930s all the way until the 80s. So be sure to stick around. All right, so what are these Kirza boots? Well, Kirza is a term for an artificial leather developed in the Soviet Union in the 1930s. Originally, after the Russian Revolution, it was extremely difficult for the Soviets to import authentic leather, and the Russian industry just couldn't supply enough leather to make boots for the new Red Army. And so, Soviet scientists developed a new manufacturing process in which they used textiles, resin, and synthetic latex to create an early synthetic leather. And the result was Kirza. Now, this particular style of boot, right, it was designed in the 1930s and first saw action in the Russo-Finnish War. Of course, that early style of Kirza proved pretty ineffective and pretty brittle in winter conditions, but it was quickly re-engineered and the style was pretty much set for the next 50 years. This style of boot, called a Jackboot, it has no laces, it comes all the way up to the knee, was used by Soviet troops through World War II and through the war in Afghanistan, where it seems like, from my research, it was really popular among tankers and BMP operators, probably because the lack of laces meant it couldn't get caught on the internals of an armored vehicle. So, where did I test it out? Well, I tested it out in Badlands National Park, which was very hot, very sunny, and I only put about 5 miles of hiking onto it, which is good, because these are probably the most uncomfortable boots I've ever worn. Because they are meant to be waterproof, they're tightly stitched leather all the way up to the knee, which means there's zero breathability. So your feet very quickly get extremely hot. My socks were actually soaked even after just a couple miles of hiking. Now, also, because there's no laces, if there are problems with the fit, you really don't have the ability to cinch them tighter or loosen them up. A bad fit is just a bad fit. And in my case, I tried my best to get the right size, but when you're ordering online and you're converting to Russian sizes, in addition to the notoriously poor Soviet manufacturing standards, you really were rolling the dice. And my dice came up short because as I hiked, the boot separated from my heel every step, creating a rubbing sensation on the back of my foot that really led to some pretty gnarly blisters. So while they look really cool, they would make a great item for a Halloween costume, and they're a neat piece of history, man, I would not take these backpacking. One upside though is that the care and maintenance of Kirza is identical to the care and maintenance of conventional leather. So I was able to clean these with my leather polish in basically the same way that I clean my black leather boots. However, if you're looking for new backpacking boots, man, just look elsewhere. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. Please like the video and comment down below if you guys have any experience with Kirza boots and Russian boot sizing. I really feel like maybe I got it wrong and that if I got the size better, maybe they would fit. But I don't know if I feel like ordering more boots from Ukraine. So until next time, I will see you guys on the trail.